Xiao Feng, get up.
Ah, Mr. Xiao, we're really grateful that you helped us. You saved our lives. Although, when the rest here, you can be sure they'll be back to get even with us for this, one way or other.
You can relax. I started this. I'll stay here and finish it.
Especially the way he killed that Jap by throwing the chopstick.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. We know none of the Japs were any match for Mr.
Right, I was behind the door. And I was watching him while he was fighting. The way he was killing off those Japs, I almost fell for them. Well, almost.
Really? So you were hiding behind the door while we were fighting, and you have the nerve to admit it, you bloody coward. You better keep your mouth shut.
Yeah. Why are you always picking on me?
I just can't stomach a coward like you. So what are you going to do then if I do pick on you?
Hey, why don't you care about that?
Hey, stop it now, you fellows. Huh? Don't fight in front of Mr. Xiao. Now sit down. There's something important to discuss. Oh, Mr. Xiao, Hung Chao is only 60 miles from here. The Japs could come at any time. Do you think there's any way that we can defend ourselves?
We don't know whether or not Hang Chao has been taken. Matter of fact, commander of Hang Chao happens to be my uncle.
Oh, so I suppose you were on your way to Hang Chao to help your uncle then.
That's right.
Oh, we'll drink to him.
Before I stopped off here, I was on my way to see my uncle, to help him fight the Japanese. Now I can't get through. The Japs are cold-blooded swine. And I'm afraid they may well have put him to death by now. In which case, maybe I'm lucky to have this opportunity of killing the Japs. At least, this way, it's possible to get my revenge. But it's not going to be an easy task to fight the Japanese army with the few men that we have. But there may be a way to defeat them. Listen to me, all of you. Every able-bodied man in this town will have to fight. I'll train them. Those of you too old to take up arms should go out and raise gold for the cause. I believe, as they've just taken Hang Chao, it will take them 10 days before they'll get here. That will give us at least 10 days to prepare our defense and give me time to go organize help throughout the countryside.
Master Shao, have you any idea of just when you're going and when you return?
I'll be going now, but I'm not sure yet when I will return. But I'll try not to be longer than 3 days. Now, during the time that I'm away, don't you forget to get things started.
All right.
These villagers are brave, but foolishly stubborn. Who'd have thought that such an insignificant village would have put up such a fight? But no one is going to stop us now.
Right.
Kawasaki.
Sir!
That commander of the Chinese army that we captured in battle, where is he now?
We've got him locked up in the dungeons.
And have you managed to persuade him to come over to our side? I want to know.
He...
Come on. Well, has he conceded?
Sir, he has resisted every one of our efforts to convince him to. In fact, he's on a hunger strike, and it looks as if he'll die soon.
He's just a stubborn old fool. I try to be fair and spare him. He's asking to get his head cut off. Tomorrow, when the sun is high, I'm going to send him and his men to join their ancestors. Bring the commander up to see me now.
Right.
Listen to me. Go through this city and collect all the valuables. And then we can begin to resupply our troops as soon as possible. Then proceed north.
Yes, sir. But sir, what about that business with the Li town?
Our mission here is to resupply our troops and to get supplies to our northern army. When we've finished here, we proceed to the beach of the war gods and join with the main force. Then we'll wipe out this Li town.
As you say, Commander.
Okay, Hsiao, we're going to stop your fasting. Today you're going to die. Get him up.
Right. Right.
Come on.
Get up.
Charles here.
Bring him here.
Sir! Bring him in now!
The last chance for you to save your life. What more is there for you to say now?
The gods are not blind to your deeds. Even as the blade falls on my neck, I will curse you so that you rot in this land and die here!
You die! Take him out and execute him.
Kill him!
Right.
At least I'm dying for my country. Not wasting my life for an evil cause. You bunch of bastards! You'll all rot in hell for this!
Believe me, I make the best swords. They're the strongest you'll find anywhere. That's because they're all made of the finest metals. Take my word for it.